So this particular reach of channel is a headwater it's a flood warning gauge, and it's the headwater of Cataract Creek, which then flows into the Havasupai village. So having a really high end model that we can then make a very accurate relationship between stage and discharge through a very large range of height will help do, hopefully before, help actually with the flood warning, in addition to really tying down how much water came through post-flood with those surveys. We're flying basically just back and forth across the river channel, and inching our way back and forth, and getting a series of overlapping photographs that can then resolve height differences within the channel. Creating these models from the air with sufficient resolution gives us a static model in time, but a living model that we can go back and we can analyze many different ways, where when we come back with the traditional survey, we're stuck with what we have and we have to put our confidence in that. So we designed a flight plan that would allow us to make a good 3D model, and so that if a flow comes through and dramatically changes the channel, we can actually assess how that's been done, go back out, fly it again, look at those roughness coefficients, look at dew change detection, look at where volumes have changed, to be able to quantify if it's a debris flow situation or it's building sandbars.
10 years, where do you see drones fitting into scientific data collection?
I think it's gonna keep evolving. This should take off here in the next year or two. We've been very fortunate to work with the Department of Interior, USGS, and the Bureau of Land Management all working together for a common goal.